So hello Ayushman, welcome to Desi Martini. It's an honor to have you here today.
Thank you, Mahima. Pleasure is mine.
So we all have loved your character in Chandigarh Kare Aashiqui. Just like all your other characters, there's only one similarity in all your other characters, that they're very different from one another. So even Manu Munjal's character is very different from anything you've done before. And I mean, for me, one of the highlights of that character was the size of your thighs. So I have to ask you, the first question is, what was your reaction when you read about Manu in the script?
Manu Munjal is a typical Chandigarh boy, Punjabi gym rat who loves to work out, is full of himself, and he's unaware, he's brash. And it was more than the character, it was the script, basically. I always go with the script more than the character. Then I look at my character. I look at the script before the character, and it had something very meaningful to convey and added a lot to my what do you say, legacy of films. And it was another feather. So I guess it was unexplored and a story needed to be told.
Wonderful. Okay, so as you've said many times before, you always listen to your heart when you decide on what next to do and what is going to be the next problem in your film. But I want to ask you, has your mind ever, you know, not agreed with your heart? Or have you ever thought maybe this is too big of a risk? And, you know, have you ever been apprehensive about any of the scripts?
I think if there's no risk, that's a risk for me. I need to take risks with films and scripts because I've made my entire career on risks. So starting with my first film and taking the filmography forward with Dam Laga Ke Isha or Shubh Mangal Savdhan or Zyada Savdhan, and then Bala, Article 15, Dream Girl, and Badhai Ho, Andhadhun. So I guess even this Chandigarh Chadh Kare Aashiqui, I would term it as my riskiest film because the subject is slightly alienated from the mainstream, or maybe people in a country are not aware about the trans world. So it was a great induction, the first big giant step towards that.
And it worked out really well for you as well as the audience.
Yeah, I'm glad that we had this successful collaboration with Abhishek Kapoor and Vani Kapoor and Pragya Kapoor and Bhushan Kumar. And we were thinking of making something which was like clutter breaking or path breaking, or which has a certain voice, and I'm glad it resonated with people.
Okay, so now you're very talented and you have a lot of talented people in your family. I remember when I spoke to your brother Apar Shakti, my question was, aapke mummy papa ne kya kha ke paida kiya aapko? Then and even your wife is so talented. I mean, I love her. But coming back to your movies and your scripts, your wife is also a filmmaker. Have you ever like ran any of your scripts past her, like, you know, just to take her opinion or something?
Absolutely. In fact, she was the one who coaxed me to do Chandigarh Kare Aashiqui. She loved the script. Yeah, she was in absolute love with the script. And she read the script before I read the script.
Oh.
Then I read the script and I loved it because I was supposed to read, you know, normally read simultaneously, but she just managed to read it before me. So it really mattered a lot. Her opinions really matter a lot. So I have Sunita D'Souza, my manager, and my wife Tahira, they read my scripts and we jam together and discuss.
Is she happy with the way your character and the film turned out?
Of course, because she's also from Chandigarh. She told me that it's the first time somebody has spoken authentic Punjabi on screen, in Hindi films, basically. And she was very happy with my character because, you know, somebody like Manu Munjal in Chandigarh, always it's a very stereotypical Punjabi character.
I think it has also worked in your favor, the fact that you're a typical Punjabi munda. Whenever somebody sees you, that's the vibe we get from you and your brother.
You know what? In fact, Manu Munjal is totally opposite. I'm not aggressive as a person. I'm not that brash. I'm more aware. And that body language of the character, Manu Munjal, is completely alien to me. So I guess it's a very different character for me. I'm not that person at all.
So that's how great an actor you are, that you're the complete opposite. But you convinced us that Manu is Ayushman. So I think that's wonderful right there.
Thank you.
So now we know what you think of Manu. I know what your wife thinks about Manu now. But what do you think about Vani's character, Manvi? Because she, Vani thinks of Ayushman as a very brave actor. I would really like to know what does Ayushman think of Vani and how she's portrayed Manvi Brar.
Vani is a very diligent and very hardworking actor. And Manvi's character is the crux of the film because it's her character which draws a lot of empathy from people. And her character is the trigger for Manu's character, for the transformation of his attitude towards life or certain things, his worldview or the way he looks at things and people. So I guess she's also a very brave actor. And she was just waiting to explore because I loved her in Shuddeshi Romance, her first film. She showed a lot of spunk. She's done a lot of big projects and successful ones too. But she was just waiting for that author-backed role which happened with Chandirkar Yashiki. And I'm glad this has happened. And I think she's an asset for the film.
Okay, great. So now the film is not just a romantic comedy. It has a lot of emotions involved. Then there's the coming out scene. Then there's the confrontation scene. There's also a scene where the audience gets a glimpse of what a sex change operation is, which is really beautifully portrayed. According to you as an actor, which was your most emotional or challenging scene to shoot?
There were three scenes which were most challenging. One was when Manu Munjal gets to know about Manvi's past. And second one was the interval scene when Manu confronts Manvi in the mall and Manvi slaps Manu. Because in these two scenes, it was a very thin line to tread. It could have gone either way. So they were difficult scenes to direct also and act also. And the third one was when outside the hospital, Manu confesses, his love for Manvi and accepts her identity. I think these three scenes form the crux of the film and the most difficult ones.
And you also had to pick up a car right after your confession.
That was a crane which picked up the car because, of course, it was like 1,500 kgs.
It looked very real.
It looked real, but that was not me. Trust me.
It's nice to see how honest people are. Okay, so Ayushman, you've always spoken about how you go for unconventional or taboo-breaking scripts generally. But I want to know, when you became an actor, when you were new in the industry, was this always the path you wanted to take? Or did you have like a different idea of where your career is going to go?
You know, I've started as a theater actor. I have been an ardent lover of Hindi commercial cinema. I've grown up watching Hindi commercial cinema. But as I was growing up, I did a lot of theater, street theater. And with street theater, we touched a lot of taboo subjects, social issues, and made plays and acts around it. So I guess this is just an extension of my theater personality because I've been doing a lot of social issues, montages during my theater days. So this is something which I was very convinced with my first film that this has to be taken forward, and this could be a new genre altogether. Because being an outsider, nobody was going to give me a big launch. So I had to do something different and unique. So I'm glad I've chosen and I've taken this path, and it's been successful, and people are liking it and loving it. And it's just not just me. I've also been very fortunate to work with great minds, with Sujit Sarkar or Shriram Raghavan, Anubhav Sinha, and Abhishek Kapoor. So I've got great directors and scriptwriters to thank for this journey.
Touch wood for that. So before you became an actor, when you were growing up, we were all watching the same films growing up. Did you ever question the logic behind some of the Bollywood films? Like any of the things, you know, which seemed very, I mean, just not possible in real life. Did you ever question that logic? Like, one day when I become an actor, I don't want to do that. Anything like that?
you know, if something is illogical, it has to be coupled with great entertainment. Like if there's a lot of audience engagement and entertainment, if you're enjoying what you're watching, then you give that liberty to the film, you know. But if it's not engaging and something illogical happening, then of course there's a problem. But if it's entertaining, I think you don't mind that kind of illogical stuff going on, because that's what you want eventually. When you spend money and go to the theater to have a good time, you know, it's a film, and every film, every genre is different. So you call it suspension of disbelief in cinema, then you give that suspension of disbelief if you are engaged and entertained. But realistic cinema is of course different. My kind of cinema is also different. But you know, it happened to Dreamgirl also, for example. There was a suspension of disbelief that a father could not recognize his own son's voice. You know, that was the biggest challenge. So if you're entertained, if you're finding it funny and you're laughing it out loud, and then you don't question anything.
Now that's so well said. But I have to say, your Dreamgirl was convincing, because your voice as a girl, it was very convincing in that. Okay, so
Dreamgirl was my most commercial film. It gathered 142 crores, so it was my most commercial front bench film. So I would love to do that again as well. But as I said, if there is no logic, there has to be entertainment.
That's very well put. Even as audience, if there is actually no logic, we'll still go and see a film if there's just entertainment. So content is very important, definitely, whether it's illogical or logical. So very well said. Okay, so now recently you mentioned in an interview that people don't expect safe things from you anymore. They always expect you to do something different. Now that obviously motivates you to, you know, try out different topics in all your films. That has worked out very well for you. You're always so inspired and motivated. But has it ever like put some extra pressure on you as an actor ki arey fir kuch different karna padega?
Jab tak kuch different mil raha hai, to tab tak theek hai. And as abhi tak to different mil hi raha hai. But I have to change my genre with every 3-4 films. First time I changed my genre with Andhadhun, then it happened with Article 15, now it'll happen with Anek, and then Action Hero. So I need to mix my films well. But yeah, all these films are unique and they are different. So till the time I'm getting different stuff, I'm nothing to complain.
So there's no pressure, absolutely no pressure. I mean, you're easy going that way.
Of course, there is pressure while choosing the script. Like the most pressure situation is when you're choosing out of hundreds of scripts and then you finalize one. Executing a film is a lot of fun because you are excited about that project. But yes, I need to keep my eyes and ears open. That's what I do. I work with first-time directors, first-time script writers. Half of my films are with first-time directors. So I have more people to, you know, entertain and talk to them and engross with them, or maybe chat or have a conversation and take narrations or read scripts. So it's a taxing job. Choosing the script is a taxing job.
Okay, so now before your film release, we saw a lot of promos where everybody came and asked you, "Is baar kya problem hai? Ab kya problem hai?" मुझे आपसे पूछना है आपकी अगली फिल्म, मतलब हमें पता है आपका भी लाइनअप क्या है छोटा सा, बट जो उसके आगे बहुत बड़ा लाइनअप बनने वाला है फ्यूचर का, उसमें ऐसी कोई प्रॉब्लम जो आप स्पेशली समथिंग यू वांट टू डिस्कस विद द ऑडियंस, समथिंग यू थिंक रियली नीड्स टू बी टच्ड?
ऐसी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है किसी आने वाली फिल्म में. कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. आई थिंक दे आर यूनिक इन देयर ओन वे. दे मे हैव अ सर्टेन वॉइस और वैल्यू एडिशन टू द सोसाइटी. But there is no problem as such.
Any problem that you feel should be discussed in some of your upcoming films? I mean, something you really feel needs to come out, because all these topics that you've discussed, even in Shubh Mangal Jyada Saavdhan, and even here in Chandigarh Kare Aashiqui, I mean, I don't know anybody could have even thought of that. We saw you and we were like, oh my God, now this is cinema. This is a different path that Ayushman Khurrana is taking. So like your next stepping stone, if you had to choose one problem.
India is full of problems. I think we are full of complexities. There's no dearth of issues in our country. So I guess, I don't know, more than me, some scriptwriter must be thinking of certain issue to be, you know, put on the celluloid. So I think it's not me who's writing this. They are amazing scriptwriters and they're great directors who work with me. So if they come up with a certain issue or which could be made into a film, then why not?
Wonderful. Okay, so before I take your leave, I don't want to, because this is like a dream come true, sitting in front of you. I mean, all I need here is Saira Kashyap and I'm good. But before I take your leave, I just have one more question for you. Is there anything you can tell us about your upcoming films, Anek, Dr. G and Action Hero?
Anek is a political thriller with Anubhav Sinha. We shot in Northeast. And then there's Dr. G with Anubhuti Kashyap, first-time director. And I'm playing a male gynecologist in the film, Dr. Gupta. That's why Dr. G. And then there's Action Hero, which I'll be shooting next in London with Anirudh Ganpati. He's also a first-time director. So a lot of first-time directors and a lot of exciting stuff coming up.
Great. We can't wait to see you on screen again. Super excited. All the very best. And thank you for this lovely, lovely, lovely chat.
Thank you, Mahima. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Good luck. Bye-bye.